Hello, friends. This is Getty. You know, a lot of you people that see me on YouTube only know me as a person who can do voices, or a person who can play drums, or maybe a person who has a very passionate view on not only politics but human nature. I always like to look into what humankind is doing and question where the drive comes from, what the intention is, where are the weaknesses, what are the strengths. But a lot of the times, I feel like people aren't really getting a full grasp of me, and I'm just putting out like these little side notes of who I am. So I just thought I'd give you guys a little bit more of a dynamic view of me. I'm also an artist. I know a lot of you have heard something about me being an artist, but never actually saw any of my artwork. So here's some of my artwork for you, and hopefully you'll like it. This is Renaissance art, because I think that the Renaissance is absolutely the most magnificent period of time from artwork that this world has ever seen. 1500s in Italy. The most brilliant minds ever. We're talking the most incredibly ingenious people. I think Leonardo da Vinci is at least 500 or 600 years ahead of his time. He's ahead of us, let's put it that way. He's still ahead of us. Way back there in the 1500s, he's ahead of us. He's been inventing things and drawing things beyond our comprehension as a whole, as a humanity. But here's some of my artwork. I drew these when I was 20, several years ago, actually. Wow. Better get back into it. But yeah, this is a rendition of a Leonardo da Vinci piece right here. Check it out. Took me about 35 minutes to draw this. I saw the original and I had to draw my own version of it. And I like it. I really do. I like my version. Here's another one I did the same day, actually. Took me about 45 minutes or so to draw this one. Also a Leonardo da Vinci piece. The way I do it is I don't just pick up a piece of paper and draw, or just look at something and draw, or imagine something and draw. You know, when you go on deck as a batter in baseball, you don't go with the bat that you use. You actually pick two or three or four bats, or a really heavy bat, and you swing it and swing it and get your muscles tuned up, ready to hit that home run, so when you go up at bat, you have no problem swinging and slugging and getting as good of a hit as possible. It's kind of like a warm-up thing you do. Well, for drawing, there is a warm-up thing that I do for drawing. Two things I do. First, I get a sheet of paper, wiggle my hands around, and get my hands ready to move and flow with the speed of thought, with the continuity of my intentions. Then, I actually get a Renaissance art book, and I open it up, and I study all the artwork that's in it. And the way I study it is I actually look at the work, let it penetrate my brain, immerse myself into the greatness. I allow the thinking that it must have taken for these Renaissance artists to create these works to unite with my own thinking. And I put myself at a plateau, almost at like a transcendental level, right? It's kind of like, I don't know, some type of meditative thing. But for me, I'm able to dive into the state of mind that these people had to create these works, because you can't just go on day-to-day living, the, you know, 2008, whatever this world is going through, living, and do works like these. I mean, these works are beyond time. They're completely timeless. They're super, superb. They're great. Phenomenal. They're divine. They truly are. So for me, I have to immerse my brain into the divine greatness before I'm able to be divinely great. You can't just jump from, you know, making dinner or putting your clothes on to this kind of artwork. It just, you have to really do your meditative things, and that's what I do. Here's one of my favorites right here, perhaps my favorite. It's a Raffaello piece, another Renaissance great. It's my rendition of it. I call it Taciturn Indignation for my own reasons, and if you want to know about them, ask me. Yeah, it took me about 4 days to do this one. All pencil and eraser. You heard that right? I actually use eraser to draw. Ask me about that one too and I'll tell you. That's it though. You know, people have this idea that I'm just one-dimensional, two-dimensional, three-dimensional, but I consider myself at least 10-dimensional. So there are so many abilities of mine people don't even know about, but I'm slowly getting them out there. Hopefully you like my Renaissance art, and I'm going to be drawing more. I have a lot to do with my time, and I don't have time for drama, guys. If you want to get in arguments or fight, just do it with someone else, please. I don't have time. But if you want to talk about artwork, you want to talk about poetry, and you want to talk about government, you want to talk about philosophy and human nature and technology and science and all these good things and wonderful things that advance the human race, I'm for it. Okay? So I hope you liked it, and stay tuned for more goodies. Subscribe. Click the subscribe button. And please replay this and show your friends. Embed the video and show your friends. Thank you very much, guys. Have a good one. Talk to you later.